तो चलिए दोस्तों, टिल क्वेश्चन नंबर 10 वी हैव डिस्कस्ड ऑलरेडी। सो इन दिस क्वेश्चन वी विल ट्राई टू डिस्कस फ्रॉम 11 टू 30। ओके, सो दिस इज द 11th नंबर क्वेश्चंस। दिस क्वेश्चन इज आल्सो फ्रॉम द फिजिक्स। सी कंटिन्यूअसली क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम फिजिक्स इट इज जस्ट कमिंग। ओके, सो नाउ स्टार्ट वी। ओके, सो ए 20 kg ब्लॉक इज प्लेस्ड ऑन अ स्मूथ हॉरिजॉन्टल टेबल। अ हॉरिजॉन्टल फोर्स ऑफ 12 न्यूटन इज अप्लाइड टू द ब्लॉक। द पोजिशन ऑफ द ब्लॉक एट 5.0 seconds is okay. Now let's come. What is the given? A 20 kg block is placed on a smooth horizontal table. Okay. So let's come. One table is there where one block is kept. Okay. Initially, this block having mass equal to 20 kg. Okay. 20 kg. Now, if I tell and they are making a horizontal force as per questions. The horizontal force is 12 newton they are making. Okay, so force equal to 12 newton they are applying here. Now we'll come to the questions. So here question is, so a 20 kg block is placed on a smooth horizontal table. A horizontal force of 12 newton is applied to the block. The position of block at 5 seconds. Okay, so let's go. So I take in here, suppose this is the x equal to 0, means initial position is 0, and t equal to 0 means no force is applied. Now let us suppose we have applied the 12 newton force here. Agar 12 newton force ka hum apply karte hain force aur mass 20 kg hai, to 5 second ke baad kya hoga? Let's assume, suppose it came here. Okay, so here x equal to, we should know what is this, only have to calculate ki kahan par position hai, what is the position, and t equal to after 5 seconds. Now given data is force is 12 newton, mass is 20 kg. So we know f equal to mass into acceleration. So from here we can make the acceleration f by m. So what is the f? 12, and m is 20 kg, newton and kg both in same. We'll calculate, then what we'll get around 5.3 means 3/5 m/s². This is the acceleration. Now you got the acceleration. Now you should know what is the displacement. This, what is the from here to here, this is x. What is the distance they went in t bar of 5 seconds? As you know, s equal to ut plus half a t square. Now up, according to question, kept in a smooth horizontal table, means it is initially in rest, means u is initial velocity. So if initially it is in rest, then u will be 0. So u into whatever things, this term becomes 0 because initial velocity is the 0. Okay, so now it's only remain half a t square. Okay, now what we got, 1/2 a is 3/5 from here. Okay, into t 5 seconds, a square t, then 5 into 5, this 5 it will come, and it will come around 7.5 meter. Okay, so 7.5 meter it came. So 7.5 meter each displacement after 5 seconds, means position will be okay. Now come to the questions. So where is the 7.5? Option B. Okay, so you got, so 7.5 answer. So option B is correct. See, this is also from physics and basic calculation. You should know force equal to mass into acceleration, and what is the s equal to ut plus half a t square. You will get the, this full marks. And from this, if you see the previous which I have took the test series of HSFC, well, you can see in applying mathematics and basic science, I clearly mentioned this syllabus, what vector plus motions. So from this all the question is coming only. So that's why I'm telling, please come to my electronics guru, electronics_guru. We having a group discussions Telegram channel. Go in there and join. And next time we are going to launch a good test series on website. You should join there. Okay, so let's come to the next. Okay, so next question is here. which of the following statement is correct? So this is, so this is from multiplex digital electronics topic. Okay, so here you will come, which of the following statement is correct? Okay, so 4:1 here is written here, or 4:1 multiplexer have 4 input line, 2 selection and 1 output line, 4:2 means all the multiplexer having 4:1. Now we should know how much input, how much the select line, how much the output. Okay, let's come here. So you know what is the block diagram of multiplexer. So these all are means if A0, B0, C0 and A, these all are input side. Okay, and in multiplexer only one output Y. Okay, this is the output, and multiplexer is written as 2n×1 in this term. Now what they are given, 4:1, so we can write 2×2×1. Okay, so 2×2×1. Okay, this is the multiplexer size. Okay, now if you will see 2×n×1, this is always a output because multiplexer having one output, and this whole you will see this is the input, and whatever the power 2n, that is the number of select line. Okay, now see here 4:1 multiplexer they given in questions. So 2×2, then 2 is the number of select line, means select line how much here, 2. Okay, so select line will be 2, and total input 2×2×4, 4 input and 1 output. So 4 input, 2 select line, 1 output. Let's come to the option. What is here, 4×1 means 4:2 multiplication have 4 input line, 2 select line, 1 output. So first option only correct. So 12 answer is A, correct answer is A. Understood? So see, this is very very basic question is came in ursc. I think the people who have studied very nicely in diploma, they will clearly very they will definitely clear this exam. But all questions are very very basic level and very easy questions. I think out of 60 it will more than 55 it will bend or cut off four selections. Okay, let's come the next questions. So 12 answer is A. Okay, 12 answer is A. I already told how it will come A. Chaliye, next question is 13. Okay, which of the following statement is correct? DPCM bandwidth requirement of DPCM is more than the PCM. Bandwidth requirement of DPCM is equal to the PCM, and PCM bandwidth requirement of DPCM is less than the PCMs, and both DPCM and PCM has the no bandwidth requirement. Okay, now you should know what is the DPCM and PCCM before attempting this the questions. Okay, here I am taking the PCM, here I am taking DPCM. Okay, now take it, my dear friend. You will see the PCM block diagram. So here one block. So this is the low pass filter. Okay, and then you will come here. This is the sampling filter. Then you will come here. This is the quantizer, and finally you will get the equalizer. Okay, and you will get the output. Okay, PCM output here, PCM output. If you'll see, they having a same sequence from here to here it is coming. Okay, now you'll see the DPCM, then it will come here, sample input will come from here directly. I'm writing here sample input will come, and this is the you having comparator circuit here, comparator. Okay, then it will go to the quantizer, then equalizer, and from here it will give the DPCM. okay, and from here another comparator will come, so same signal came or not came, and here will come a prediction filter, you can write PF, and its input will go to here. Okay, so now you will see here what in PCM no feedback is there, but here one feedback circuit is there in DPCM. And if you will see the remotely analog signal into digital signal, these are all the signals what we are doing DPCM and PCM, both are doing remodeling, means analog signal whatever you having, they are remodeling to a digital signal. like that. So they are remodeling analog signal to a digital signals, and compared to the PCMs, this DPCM is a simple circuit, but PCM is a complex circuits, and PCM we will require very high bandwidth. While you will see DPCM compared to PCM, that will require less bandwidth. Okay, so if you will see the what is the samples of the PCM, then it in PCM that will come 7 bit per 8 sample output they will give, but here in DPCM it will give 4 bit per 6 sample. So see here, PCM having the higher bandwidth than DPCM. Okay, so understood, PCM having higher bandwidth than DPCM. Okay, so let's come the on questions here. So DPCM will come here. So bandwidth kind of DPCM more than the PCM. Okay, that is incorrect. I already told this is the incorrect. PCM having higher bandwidth than DPCM. Bandwidth required from DPCM is equal to, this is also incorrect. PCM bandwidth required from DPCM is less than the PCM. Yes, DPCM having less than the PCM bandwidth requirement, I already told. So 13 option is correct, option is C. Okay, so chaliye next mein aate 14th number mein. Here is question is the electric field due to a point charge at a distance r is, come here. So you will see a point charge. Okay, one point charge there, q. Okay, let's q. So as you know, every charge particle have a static field. If charge particle is rotating, then have the magnetic field. Okay, so a static charge particle create electric field, while rotating charge particle create magnetic field. Okay, so due to this q, I find a point a, suppose, where distance of the r, what will be the electric field due to this charge particle here. Okay, so the electric field intensity at a distance r due to a charge particle q is 1 beta 4 pi epsilon naught into q by r square. Okay, this is the electric field intensity at a distance r due to any charge particle. Okay, so you can directly write, this is the constant, so we can write E equal to k into q by r square, where k value is, as you know, you will epsilon naught is 9.988 unit 10 to power minus 12 meter farad per meter. As you know, I will and 1 by 4 pi will calculate all, then you will get 8.88 into 10 to power 9 newton meters per coulomb square. So here I will come electric field, what is, E is k into q by r square. If k is a constant, we will remove the proportionality things, then E will directly proportional to q by r square. Yeah, I can tell E is inversely proportional to 1 by r square. Now come to the option. Okay, E is inversely proportional to 1 by r square. So let's come the questions. So the electric field due to point charge at distance r is inversely proportional to r square. So option D is a correct option. I already here I told option D is correct answer. Okay, here you already know E is inversely proportional to 1 by r square. Okay, understood? Any questions, any confusion, please comment in my comment box. Okay, so chaliye next 15 numbers. So 15 number is, a car initially traveling at a 30 km per hour accelerate at a constant of 1.5 meter per second square. How far the car travel in 15 seconds? Okay, now this question is also from physics. See how much question is coming from physics, my dear friend. So here is also we'll come to our next page. So a car initially traveling at 30 km per hour accelerate, means initial velocity is 30 km per hour, at a constant of 1.5 meter per second square, means they having the acceleration, they having initial velocity. How far the car travel in 15 seconds. Okay, here it is give C. Now you have to convert the unit. Here is kilometer per hour, here is meter per second square, and here is second. So all the thing you have to convert in SI unit, means kilometers would come meter per second. Okay, so according to questions, here will come. So you given how much? 30 kilometer per hour. So directly you can convert this in 30 into 5 by 18, then it will come like that 15 9, and it will come around 3 and 5, it's come 25 by 3 meter per second. This is the initial velocity. Acceleration, we know how much acceleration they given, 1.5 meter per square. Okay, now let's come here. Now as we know, s equal to ut plus half at square. Okay, initial velocity how much they given, 25 by 3, and t how much they given in question, after they are telling 15 second after. So into 15 plus half a acceleration having be 1.5 into t again 15 square, then 15 into 15, we calculate here 5, and here around 1.5 is calculated, then we calculate, then it will come 293.75 meter. Okay, so we'll see option what is here, 293.75 meter. Okay, here you come. So 293.75 meter, option D is a correct answer. Okay, so you know two formula you should know, only one formula, s equal to ut plus half at square. And one thing you should know, if any kilometer per hour is there, you just multiply with 5 by 18, it will come meter per square. If meter per second square you have to calculate in kilometer per square, then you just multiply with 18 by 5. Okay, so it's okay. So option D is the correct. 15 number now will come. 16 questions is there. 16, a transformer has 350 primary turns and 150 secondary turns. The primary winding is connected across a 230 volt 50 hertz supply. The induced EMF in the secondary will be okay. Now you know V primary by N2 equal to V secondary by N1. Is it correct? V. So if you want to secondary, then what you have to do? No, this is not correct. So V1 by N1 equal to V2 by N2. Okay, so this is a transformer from the machines, electrical machines. I already can tell the basic electronics also. So transformer has the 350 primary, means N1 is given and N2 given, means 1050 secondary turn, and primary winding is connected 230 volt, means V primary is there. And always know transfer is a device, electrical device, which change the one power level to another power level and without changing in frequency. So frequency we need not to worry, always secondary side will come 50 hertz only. Now they are telling what is the secondary voltage. Okay, so now you write V1 by N1 equal to V2 by N2. So we want to know V2, so V2 equal to V1 N2 by N1. Okay, so V1 is how much, 230 volt, and N2 is here N2, then 1050. Why V1 is how much, 350. 350 will calculate here, then it will come around 690 volt. So secondary side will come 690 volt. But now you have to what you did here and here. Now I already told in transformer they are not changing the frequency, so that's why this 150 hertz is wrong. 150 is wrong, so only 690 volt with 50 hertz will come to the secondary side. So option is A, A option is correct. 16, A option is correct. Okay, next. 17, if a transmission line is terminated with a resistance equal to its characteristic impedance. Okay, so what will be the reflection coefficient? Will be unity, standing wave ratio will be minimum, and the line loss will be maximum and the input impedance will be twice the thermal resistance. Four option is here. We'll see what is the correct answer. Okay. Now they are telling measured with the resistors equal to the characteristic impedance. Okay. So as you know, reflection coefficient equal to 1 minus reflection coefficient equal to reflected voltage by V forward voltage. Suppose one transmission line is there, here your load is there. So whatever will be you are sending, this is the forward voltage, and after due to this load, if anything will coming back here reflected, that is the reflected voltage. And tau equal to, we can also write ZL minus Z naught by Z naught plus ZL. Okay. Now they are telling according to the question, so ZL equal to the Z naught. Okay. So put here. So here will come reflection coefficient equal to ZL minus Z naught by ZL plus Z. Okay, and VSRW standing wave ratio is there equal to, we can write VSR equal to 1 minus reflection coefficient plus 1 by reflection coefficient. Now according to question, they given ZL equal to Z naught. Okay. So now here come, we'll put ZL equal to Z naught. So Z naught minus Z naught by Z naught plus Z naught. So it will come upside 0 by 2 Z naught. So anything by 0 is 0. This reflection coefficient is 0. Means nothing is coming to reflected back from load side. Okay. So what will the according what they are asking, so nothing will is coming from Z naught. So reflection coefficients come here 0, means you have ideally 0 reflections, means you are sending something to a transmission line and terminated will be equal to Z naught equal to ZL, means ZL equal to Z naught. So whatever you will send perfectly it will go to the load, nothing will reflect it back toward the source. So ideally it will 0, but due to some anything is not perfect, so very very minimum compared to 0 reflection will come. So now it will come to the option. Okay, now option is here, if you see, so we got ZL equal to 0, so reflection will be unity, this is wrong. Shutting wave ratio will be minimum, yes. The line loss will be the maximum, this is wrong because already perfectly matched, so loss will be less, very 0 compared to, and the input impedance will be the twice the thermoelectric resistance, wrong. Z naught equal to ZL they told. So the shutting wave ratio will be very minimum. I already told what is the already you will get reflection coefficient equal to 0, then a standing wave equal to 1 minus 0 by 1 plus 0, means 1 by 1 equal to 1. A standing wave is 1, means the reflection will be very very, means perfectly matched and no reflection. Okay, so in this case option is B, because reflection coefficient is 0, means nothing is coming. So standing wave ratio will be very very minimum. Okay, a load is perfectly matched. Now 18 number question is here, express the power dissipation in 100 ohm resistance in dv related to 1 milliwatt when the voltage across the resistors is 1 volt RMS. Okay, so let's come in questions what they are given. V RMS equal to 1 volt. Okay, so V RMS equal to 1 volt they given. So as you know, power dissipation is always equal to V square RMS by R. Okay, so here V RMS is 1 and resistance according to question they given 100 ohm, so 1 by 100 watt is your PD. Now we have to calculate in decibel. So in any power in decibel is 10 into log P output by P input. Okay, they are telling compared to 1 milliwatt part will be there. So 10 log 1 by 100 by 1 into 10 to power minus 3. Okay, because 10 millivolt means 10 milliwatt means 10 to power minus 3, 1 milliwatt means, sorry. So it will go upside, it will come 1000 by 100, 10 log 1000 by 100. So it will cut, so it will come inside, it will come 10. So 10 into log 10 base into 10 equal to 1, so it will come, so 10 dB. So what is the power attenuated edge? 10 dB only. So we will see the option. What is the option? Where is the option? Our 10 dB. So option C is a correct. So 18 number, option C is a correct. Okay, so option C, 10 dB is 18, C option. Okay, now it will come question number 19. What is the 19? A tuned circuit is resonant at 4 MHz, its Q is 100, the bandwidth is, okay. As you know, a Q means quality factor is equal to resonance frequency by bandwidth. So bandwidth equal to resonance frequency by Q. What is the resonance frequency here? 4 into 10 to power 6 MHz by 100. So we will calculate this, we will get 40 kilohertz, 2 to 10 to power 4 means 40 kilohertz. Okay, so where is option? Option A is a correct. Option 19, option A. Okay, next 20 number. The 20 number is here. What is the modulation index in frequency modulated signal with a carrier frequency of the 100 megahertz, modulated frequency of 4 kilohertz, and frequency division of 50 kilohertz? Okay, now see here, as we know, a frequency according to Calzerun in FM, bandwidth equal to 2 into 2 FM, we can write in Sodale plus 1, where this is the modulation index. Okay, now we'll see the modulation index. Then modulation index is equal to deviation, maximum deviation by maximum frequency of the message. Okay, so what is here maximum deviation? Maximum deviation is here 50 kilohertz frequency deviation. Okay, so what is the modulation? The modulation frequency is 40 kilohertz. So 50 by, I already told, modulation is equal to the frequency deviation by FM means message frequency. So modulation deviation, how much deviation they given? Frequency deviation 50 kilohertz. And what is the modulation frequency? 50 kilohertz. So you can tell the modulation equals by 50 by 4 equal to 12.5. Where is option? Option C is the correct answer. Okay, so 20C. So already 20 minute over, 23 minute. Okay, so we will continue in next video till 21 to whatever it will be possible. My dear friend, the time is taking more because I am explaining the concept and all the item behind this, the questions. That's why it is taking the more time. Okay, so bear with us and wait for the next video. Thank you.